is Emil Franchel, and I am a psychologist specializing in hypnotism. You are about to see a preview of the most fantastic advance ever to be made in the history of motion picture entertainment, called HypnoVista. It is a psychological technique whereby you, seated in the auditorium, actually become part of the action you see on the screen.
Watching this screen, look out, because soon, very soon, the most horrifying monster menace ever conceived will be oozing into this theater.
Now, where do you suppose they're going? And just when it was getting good? Well, I guess they're not the first audience to leave a horror movie screaming, either from pure terror or from bad acting. But then, that was always the beauty of fright pictures. You didn't go to observe the subtle application of the thespian art. You went to be scared out of your wits, to eat your popcorn and candy, while you tried to convince your buddies, or if you were lucky, your girlfriend, that you weren't really scared. You were merely shielding your eyes from the bright screen. You went to live a waking nightmare, filled with the unbelievable, the unnatural, and more often than not, the undead.
It has been established that persons who have recently died have been returning to life and committing acts of murder. A widespread investigation of reports from funeral homes, morgues, and hospitals has concluded that the unburied dead are coming back to life and seeking human victims. So now let's go to that film report.
If I were surrounded by 6 or 8 of these things, would I stand a chance with them?
Well, there's no problem. If you had a gun, shoot them in the head. That's a sure way to kill them. If you don't, get yourself a club or a torch. Beat them or burn them. They go up pretty easy.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Kind of makes you want to go to the refreshment stand, doesn't it? I mustn't forget to get the name of their tailor. Matinee monsters were usually played by unknown actors. But while most disappeared into obscurity, some later traded their fangs for stars. Here's one you might recognize, about to have a little howl on the prairie. Of course, terror didn't always have a recognizable face. In fact, sometimes it didn't have a face at all, or even a body, for that matter. Played with such a heavy hand. Some movies and actors invited a little nervous laughter in between the screams.
Hard place to keep clean, huh?
Yes, I very seldom get down here.
Oh.
Forgive me, Papa. don't know. I suggest we better leave here, huh?
Yes.
Don't forget my hair. Come on, hurry up.
Perhaps he was referring to the critics. And speaking of someone getting a big hand. But while some didn't want a hand, others could have definitely used one.
Are you ready now, Bartholomew?
Hardly a lack of dangerous dungeons. But more often than not, the growing menace came from the sky and beyond.
The way that putty in my closet was formed. Miles, where do they come from?
I don't know. If they are seeds or seed pods, they must grow someplace on a plant, probably. And somebody or something wants this duplication to take place.
But when they're finished, what happens to our bodies?
I don't know. When the process is completed, probably the original is destroyed or disintegrates.
Scott.
No, wait!
Right, but I take a dim view of watching my own destruction take place.
There isn't any danger until they're completely formed. We learned that last night at your house. Your blank didn't change right away.
Not until you fell asleep. Miles, when the change does take place, do you suppose there's any difference?
There must be. Wilma noticed it. So did little Jimmy.
So did I. My father.
Jack, thank God. Jack, the whole town's been taken over by the pods.
Not quite. There's still you and Becky. Miles, it would have been so much easier if you'd gone to sleep last night.
Now, relax. We're here to help you.
You know better than that.
Where do you want us to put them?
Would you like to watch them grow?
No, thanks.
Put them in there. There's nothing to be afraid of. We're not going to hurt you.
But once you understand, you'll be grateful. Remember how Teddy and I fought against it? Well, we were wrong.
You mean Teddy doesn't mind?
Of course not. She feels exactly the way I do.
Let us go.
Look, we'll leave town. We won't come back. We can't let you go. You're dangerous to us.
Don't fight it, Miles. It's no use. Sooner or later, you'll have to go to sleep.
I'll wait for you in the hall.
Miles, you and I are scientific men. You can understand the wonder of what's happened. Now just think. Less than a month ago, Santa Mara was like any other town. People with nothing but problems. Then out of the sky came a solution. Seeds drifting through space for years took root in a farmer's field. From the seeds came pods, which have the power to reproduce themselves in the exact likeness of any form of life.
So that's how it began. Out of the sky.
While some nightmares assumed recognizable shapes, others had no shape at all.
Dave! Doc Hallen's been killed.
Doc Hallen? What happened?
It's over at his place. You gotta come now.
Wait a minute, Steve. Tell us what happened.
Well, I'm trying to tell you. Now, this thing had killed the doc.
But what was it? Stop with it, kid. Well, it's kind of like a... It's kind of like a mass that keeps getting bigger and bigger.
Teenagers see it first, like a falling star from outer space.
Boy, that was close. Hey, come on, I want to see if I can find it.
An old man finds it, touches it, and this is the shocking result. From then on, there's no stopping the blob as it spreads from town to town. It's indestructible. It's indescribable. Nothing can stop it.
This town is in danger.
How can it be stopped? Mob hysteria sweeps one city. Before long, the nation and then the world could fall before the blood-curdling threat of the Blob.
Starring Steve McQueen and a cast of exciting young people.
Meanwhile, others were engaged in the little hand-to-hand combat of their own. Of course, you went to the theater for the main feature, but almost as important were the previews of what terrors next week held in store for you. The movie trailers were often as good as the movies, and sometimes a lot better. As they informed you of your next cinematic experience in their own quiet, modestly understated way.
Headlines of the world blaze the fabulous story of this monster from another age, catapulted from some vast sub-ocean cavern by unprecedented volcanic action. And the headlines scream the story of the reckless skin divers who captured the monster and put it on exhibition.
Hurry, hurry, hurry to see Gogo!
But the headlines do not record the story of a little boy who had a curious sympathy and understanding for the fantastic creature.
How big would a full-grown one be?
An approximate guess.
the infant, the adult.
That'll make it nearly 200 feet tall.
Wreaking terrible vengeance against the civilization that has captured its offspring. Towering over the cities of the world as millions flee its awesome terror.
Revenge! Revenge while you still can! Revenge!
Nothing can stop it. Defying the force of the army. The might of the navy.
Fire number one, Harry.
Even the fury of the jets. In a crashing crescendo of sights never before beheld by human eyes and adventures never before experienced by any man or woman.
Terror is the soft, cold caress of the raven's wing.
Now, what is it you need?
You got some dried blood or a bat in the house?
Help! Help!
A raven will take you careening through the darkest of dangers. Into the ominous mystery of a master magician's evil castle.
The Screaming Skull is a motion picture magnificent in its horror. Therefore, this certificate assures burial service without cost to anyone in the audience who dies of fright while seeing The Screaming Skull. Flown a captive to a West Coast metropolis in an army cargo plane, his arrival catapults the whole city into an ocean of fear. For this colossal beast is at war with the world, our world, a world his savage instincts can only hate.
An airlift is being set up and food will be parachuted down to him. He'll be supplied with everything he needs.
Get all the aircraft into the air at once.
Colossal Man is loose in Los Angeles.
Look! Look at the giant!
It's the civilized world in blood-freezing horror as the immeasurable power of this colossal beast threatens a war of brutality such as we've never known.
See, War of the Colossal Beast and Attack of the Puppet People.
Friend.
See, the world that the child in each of us knows.
What are you talking about?
Sally.
Tell her. He said that tonight. He said tonight he was going to kill us all.
It only takes one of us to go for help.
Feel the fantastic fear of living in a normal world, but being dwarfed by people many times your size.
Rampaging in an unsuspecting world, living creatures from the dawn of time. What havoc will they wreak? What lives will they destroy? What depths of panic and terror will they create? most amazing, astounding, astonishing adventure of them all. Beyond anything your mind can imagine. Never before seen on the screen. It started when the Earth passed through a storm of meteorites that transformed a strange breed of carnivorous plants known as trippids into flesh-eating, man-killing monsters. This same awesome phenomena destroyed the sight of all who watched it, blinding almost the entire world.
Is he blind too?
Blind.
For those who could still see, it was a world of unimaginable horror.
Why shouldn't we survive?
Well, in France alone, there's over 50 million people, almost every one of them blind.
Paris, paralyzed by shock. London, stricken by fearsome disaster. And on all sides, trippids.
Doesn't seem to have any central nervous system.
Then how does it move?
All plants move. They don't usually pull themselves out of the ground and chase you.
The Day of the Trippids. Starring Howard Keel, Nicole Moray, Janet Scott, Kieran Moore, in a flesh-crawling experience in terror.
You want to stop watering your rhododendron, doesn't it? Well, our feature presentation is about to begin. I hope you've enjoyed our chilling little chat as much as I have. There's nothing like a good shiver to bring people closer. So why not pop a little popcorn, turn out the lights, and enjoy an eerie movie soon. Just make sure there's a hand nearby to hold. Preferably with a live body attached to it.